Hey, 你好，大家好。Hi, I just want to do a quick video on a Rotop 8.8 IPS screen that has CarPlay as well as Android Auto. What's unique about this feature is basically you don't need to change the dash. So some of you have seen my other video where I replaced this with a SATA head unit, which enables me to have CarPlay and Android Auto. With the Mitsubishi Outlander PHEV, what that means is effectively you lose some of the EV data that's on the MMCS. So with this unit, it's just basically an additional screen, almost like a sat nav, which enables you to have Android Auto and CarPlay. And what's very good about it, this is basically it's got Bluetooth into the head unit, and then Bluetooth into your iPhone into the head Rotop, and then basically Bluetooth into your head unit. So it's just booting up here, so the MMCS loads up and it's wireless Apple CarPlay, and it automatically connects to the MMCS. See, that's perfect, and it's wireless CarPlay. So what's great about this is actually it's integrated into your car steering controls as well. So if I go to audio, if I go to, say, a playlist, okay, now I'm just going to use the car controls to change the tracks. There, it's changed track. So it's a little bit slow, but I think that's because somehow it's wirelessly controlled and it's a little bit slow, but it's still pretty good. See, it's pretty good. Hey Siri, drive to Wembley Park.
Getting driving directions to Wembley Park Station. Starting route to Wembley Park Station.
So this is all integrated into the, it's not integrated, it's basically Bluetoothing the audio into the head unit. So hence, it's a pretty nice portable CarPlay Android solution. So I quite like it. It's very different because I had the SATA previously, and I put in back the original head unit, so I was obviously lacking CarPlay and Android Auto. But with this solution here, I have the original EV information that's available on the head unit, but also at the same time I have CarPlay. Okay, let me know your thoughts.